Hello, welcome back to my channel. Bienvenidos a mi canal. Today will be a very interesting video. Today is May 9th and today's video is going to be un poquito en español and a little bit in English. Why? Because tomorrow is Día de las Madres and I wanted to do something special, so I did a multilingual bilingual video. Un video donde voy a estar hablando en español y también I'm going to be talking in English, so that you guys can catch up. Press the little CC, it'll be right here or over here, I'm not sure. Donde puedes poner los subtítulos en español or subtitles in English. I will be providing both in case you don't know or don't understand both languages mientras los hablo, porque voy a estar brincando de un lenguaje al otro. Why? Because I can. Vamos a empezar. Hoy este video va a ser uno muy especial porque voy a tener... So today's video, I'm going to do something that was pretty popular a couple months ago. It was like a I recreate video, pero voy a recrear el maquillaje de mi mom de a couple years ago. So there's this picture in my family of my mom. In my family, there's this picture of my mom que yo siempre lo he visto desde que estaba chiquita. Y siempre it would make me believe that my mom was a queen, which she is. But I was like, oh, mirando esta foto, mi mamá se me parecía como una reina. Y siempre va a ser ella para mí. But this convinced me that I was a princess. I was like, oh, no. My mom's a queen, so I'm a princess. So I wanted to recreate the look that she had in this picture. Entonces les voy a enseñar la foto. También voy a ponerla por ahí. This is the picture of my mom. They say we look like. But esta es la foto de mi mamá. And salió in a wedding. I don't know how old she was here. I think estaban todavía de novios, mi mom y mi dad. But I'm going to try to recreate this amazing, like, 80s look on her eye. And it's going to be hard because I don't even think I have those colors. But I'm going to try. Because the look is hard, because it's a look that I've never done before, I am going to empezar con mis ojos. So I'm going to start with my eyes. Voy a empezar con los ojos y ojalá salga todo bien. So voy a empezar con una base para ojo. This one's from Morphe. It's the eye primer. Y lo voy a empezar como base para las sombras. Y ya que pusimos eso, I'm going to zoom in a little bit so that you can see my eyes more. So voy a empezar con una sombra color piel. Usa cualquier sombra que tienes que es color de tu piel. Okay, this video is going to have a whole bunch of different palettes because I don't have those specific colors, so I'm going to try to recreate it in cualquier manera que pueda porque no tengo esos colores. So yo voy a empezar con one palette and then I'm gonna hop to another one y después voy a agarrar otro y nomás les voy a enseñar los colores que uso. No son necesariamente del mismo palette, es como color piel hueso. Yeah. Hueso, no piel. Y lo voy a usar como base para sellar la base que acabamos de poner. Pues sí, now that we put that first base color, voy a agarrar un color medio gris. Sí, because this is like a grayish blue, teal, a little bit more cool tone. Que sea más así, no cálido, not warm. So voy a empezar con este color de aquí. A fluffy brush. It's not too much, but because this is like a weird crease, voy a tratar de mantener el color arriba del pulido. I think it was called this part, the crease. I haven't done this in a while. Give me a break. Okay. So voy a mantener el color arriba de la pliegue. Pulido. I think I just made up that word. De la pliegue. And it's okay if you mess up. Que vamos a usar some concealer to just erase any mistakes. Voy a usar este color que es como un color jade, like jade color. I'm going to try to do this right here because it looks like it's like, no es como ala, no es curved pues, it's like pretty straight, so I don't know how I'm gonna do that, but I'm gonna try. Voy a usar una brocha más apuntada y con ese mismo color. So I'm gonna use the same color until I get the shape that I want and I'm happy with. Voy a estar jumping back and forth from the transition to the el color que es como jade. También hay un poquito de blue, so I'm going to use a little bit of blue closer to the outer edge just to give it some blue. Yeah. Y el azul that I'm going to use is this one right here. It's a little dark, but I'm going to use a little bit. And I'm just going to mantener este color en la orilla. Poquitito, poquitito. En la orilla, pero más abajito. So, no tan arriba. Y este nomás lo estoy usando para darle un poquito más definición. To the eye. So that's not so just one color. Yummy. Yeah. Pero sí voy a quitar un poquito de aquí. Because there's like a negative space. And then it connects with the eyeliner. I don't know how I'm gonna do that, but yeah. So now, voy a hacer lo que acabo de hacer on this side to that side. I think así lo vamos a dejar because then we're gonna ruin it. So, ahora is the time for that really hard part that I was not looking forward to. Okay, voy a hacer un poquito de concealer and a little defining brush. And I'm gonna use this to make that sharp ass line and negative space. Voy a usar una brocha straight to try to do that. Okay, so voy a usar esta brocha for eyeliner para ver si no sale. So, voy a hacer lo mismo to the other side and we'll be right back. She doesn't have anything on here, but it's not as claro as this color que tengo aquí. Está un poquito más así cremoso y más y matte, but I mean, you can't even see it, so I have to tengo que inventarme algo porque no alcanzo a ver todo. So, that means que puedo hacer lo que quiera, right? Puedes usar este color aquí y también en el mismo con el color que tenemos puedo usar este color aquí y lo voy a poner en todo el ojo. Vamos a hacer el eyeliner. So, el eyeliner lo tiene desde aquí y sale para allá. Okay, nomás voy a empezar con lo del medio, lo de adentro primero, porque I have to do the same thing to the other side, and it's going real hard. So I'm gonna start with the bottom, so that she has an eyeliner that goes straight, and then a little bit winged. So. It's mostly hard because it's a negative space. So, hay un como espacio negativo donde lo de arriba se despega de lo de abajo. Okay, so creo que we're closer now to the eye look, but I think I want more negative space, so I'm going to try to take that off with a little bit of makeup remover and a very small little brush and hope that works out. Actually, that's not gonna work. I already figured it out. Okay, I'm going to use some concealer. Okay, con un poquito de corrector. Voy a tratar de aumentar the negative space. So, good luck, Karina. I am going to try to do that connection thing by bringing out this eyeshadow that I have a little bit this way, and then I think we'll be done. Oh my god. Okay, ya nos pusimos las lashes, and now I'm just going to touch up some of the eyeliner. Okay, and I'm just going to do my lower lash line. Okay, y yo creo que ya casi terminamos. Deme un segundito. Hola! So, we are finished. This was way harder than I thought. I did manage to do that weird empty eyeliner look that somehow was in back then. And I guess it continues to be. Me gustó mucho cómo me salió. Estuvo muy más super difficult compared to how I thought it was gonna come out. Pensé que iba a estar super fácil porque era un look de... So I thought this 80s look was gonna be easier, pero no, no era fácil para nada. Estuvo un poquito difícil. Y se me está cayendo el pelo. This is the final look. I really hope you guys enjoyed this. Feliz Día de las Madres. Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers, to my mother, to mothers to be, to mothers that, you know, all mothers, you know, anything that's considered a mother, happy Mother's Day. And thank you very much for watching this video. I'm on this side so you can continue to see my mom. I really hope you enjoyed this video. Feliz Día de las Madres, Happy Mother's Day, and see you the next time.